Hallelujah. Church, all we need is the Lord here today. Amen. What a presence of just the rays of sun to hit our face, to hit our lives, and truly to be touched by God in so many areas within our lives, and to see the healing power of Jesus working through our lives, and how the many issues and things, the situations, the problems, the circumstance, I mean, so many things that we have to go through as people of God. And you know how wonderful it is to know that that's all who we need. That's all who He is. And when we put God first in so many ways, that doesn't mean that we're gonna be less of these situations or problems. But thank God that we have a God that heals. We have the God that saves. We have the God that delivers, that He touches us, He ministers to us, you know, and He fills us where the cup then in our life is being, you know, overworked, and in the sense where I'm saying where it's overflowing over in the goodness of God and the love of God and the peace of God. And you know, it comes back and it brings that word of God back to my life, you know. And I've been using it here for these couple of days, not only casting your care upon the Lord because He cares for you, amen. And that's the truth. He does care for us. And so I know it's so hard. We want to carry our own burdens. We feel like we're strong enough. We can do this. God, let me just set you aside and let me do this on my own. Let me figure this out, you know. And you think, okay, grabbing the remote control is going to heal your problems. When we have to have prayer, we have to have supplication, we have to go before God, we have to go in the Word of God. Come on now, we can't just pull out the Bible like a magic wand and say, you know, bibbidi bobbidi boo, and then all of a sudden, you know, we have the house, we have the car, we have the increase, we have what we want. When God is saying, is that truly what you need? You know, I'm the Almighty God. I'm the resourceful God as well. You know, God knows how to save some scraps. Come on now. Because even with the loaves and the fishes that were given out to the thousands out of, you know, the two or three barley loaves and the two or three fish and the lunch sack that the young boy had, you know, he still told the disciples to keep what was left. To keep what was left. And how many were left over? And it was so much more than what even they started out. I mean, there was so much still overflowing. And it's not because God is cheap. No, God is resourceful. And He brings so much life into our life that's where the life of God in our life is pouring out into the life of others. See, we have to be fed. We have to eat. We have to drink. We have to have those resources inside our lives before we can ever give out anything. It's just like the mother. You know, she goes into the kitchen, and I'm not saying she eats first, but you know, she's got to see what she's got. And mothers, we have to be creative. We have to be resourceful. We have to see what there is. And, you know, that's where some of these main dishes that have came up is because of being resourceful and saying, oh, I can do this and I can do that. You know why? Because when it came in hard times, that's all we had. You see what I'm saying? Those potato tacos, you come to find out, hey, they're pretty tasty. Maybe you didn't have any meat in the cover. Maybe, you know, we didn't have that steak while you wait. But yet you have potatoes. And so sometimes, you know, of course the Lord makes a way where there seems to be no way. But also too, he knows the processes that, you know, we're having to go through until we get to the level or to be resourceful and be that flow where God wants us to be and to have. We have to know how to be givers. We can't just be, oh, I'm takers in this gospel. You know, if you're taking, you're receiving from somewhere, you're getting from somewhere. So that life of Christ has to flow out of you so that the blessing can continually to flow into your life. And you have to know how to give out in faith. Because giving out in faith, saying, even when I don't have it, Lord, I'm going to trust you because you're asking me, so I'm going to trust you in this. I'm going to believe you in this. I'm going to believe you here and this increase that I need in my life. Because God is, he's not just a resourceful God. I mean, he is the resources. You know, the Lord says that he has made it all and all is in him. And you know, this morning, I'm bringing you back to the Word of God. I'm bringing you always back to the Word of God, these focus points. I mean, God kicked off truly this Sunday with about the Word of God and how it is so important. And you know, we've been confessing this Word of God for our health, for our body, for our lives, and our distresses and our troubles. Come on, those who received the Word yesterday, I'm telling you, God is a good God. And he's showing how much he loves us. He loves us so very much that he gave his life. He gave his last breath. He gave his last tears of blood. I mean, he gave his last of everything that had to deal with every drop of every side eye of his body. You know, our body belongs to him. Everything belongs to him. And sometimes we feel like, oh, this is my body. You know, greater is he that lives in me than he that is of the world. Where is he living at? He's living inside of us. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the great I am, the supplier, our Jehovah Jireh, lives in us. He knows your needs. He knows your wants. He knows the desires of your heart. But we have to realize that he's the one that's residing inside of us. And we have to align all of our desires, all of our intake, all of our blessing. We got to line that up according to the Word of God. We got to align our lives according to the Word of God. And how are we going to align our lives when we don't take the time in prayer? Now, they call me Mama. In these third world countries, Mama, I need some help. See, Mama's got the belt out today. Hello. And I know you're probably laughing at me. But Mama not only loves, Mama knows how to bring correction. And we got to pick up the Word of God. We have to spend time in prayer. We got to believe for God's increase in our lives, spiritually, physically, mentally. I mean, this year, different places where we're going, expanding the borders. And, you know, we got to expand our borders mental and our mental realm as well as our physical realm. And it's not just always about having to get, how about having to give? Because in order to receive, we have to know how to give as well and give out of that blessing. You know, we're going to store up riches in heaven. Come on now. We're going to store up those riches in heaven. That when we need that arm, when we need that leg, when we need that liver, when we need that eye, when we need that tendon, when we need that muscle, when we need that finger, when we need that leg, we need that arm, when we need that finger. You know what? We got a heavenly bank. And God has all these things that we need. You know, it was beautiful to see the pastor to receive his liver. That all I could remember is him waiting to receive. And, you know, he gives into different ministries. God has led him to want to build and do different things. Now, rather, this is the thing. Are you going to do it? Are you going to do it? Are those resources there for you, just for you? Or are these resources will come in to be able to build and to edify the body, the church? I mean, are we caring? Are we giving? Are we loving? Are we sharing? You know, I'm just breaking the ice here on this word of God that I'm going to be sharing with you here today. Because that's what I'm doing right now. But let us go ahead and go into this word of God. Amen. Let us ask the Lord. Father, I thank you, Lord, for increasing us in and through this word of God. Lord, I trust you with my life, my heart, my soul, my mind. Father God, let everything that I am adore you. Let everything that I am to praise you. Let everything that I am to worship you. And I thank you, Lord, that you have caused me to praise you. You have caused me to worship you. You have caused me to lift your name on high and having hearts and fullness of thanksgiving in the mighty name of Jesus. Turn the word of God with me there in the book of Hebrews. And I know as we read it that you will know what I'm talking about and how we're going to expand on the word of God through the truth of the word of God. Hebrews there in chapter 4, we're going to go ahead and start in 1. Well, the Lord is talking about that there is a Sabbath rest for the people of God. You know, our rest is serving in the Lord. Our rest is when the Lord says, you know what? Rest. This is not in your strength. This is not in your own self, like in your own encouragement. No, we have to be encouraged through the word of God. We have to be enlightened through the word of God. And there in chapter 4, verse 1, the word reads, therefore, since the promise of entering his rest, that still stands. So let us be careful that none of you be found to be fallen short of it. Can you imagine? When it is time to rest, that we are still tilling the ground. When will the ground be rested? See, for we have also have had the good news proclaimed to us, just as they did. But the message they heard was of no value to them, because they did not share the faith of those who obeyed. Why was it no value to them? Because they did not share the faith of those who obeyed. And now, we who have believed, we entered that rest. just as God has said, and so I declared on oath in my anger that they shall never enter my rest. See, when God has led you to do something, that means we have to obey. We have to do it. Because when we don't do it, it just like we cross over into doing our own works and doing our own will versus resting in God. See, therefore, since it still remains for some to enter that rest, and since those who formerly had the good news they proclaimed to them did not go in because of their disobedience. See, God is looking for a people that is obeying. And God again set a certain day and calling it today. Today's the day. See, this he did when a long time later, when he spoke through David, as in the passage that was already quoted, he said today that if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts. See, for if Joshua had given them rest, God would not have spoken later about another day. See, if Joshua had given them rest, God would not have spoken later about another day. See, when you didn't rest this time, okay, now I'm going to speak of another time. See, there remains then the Sabbath rest for the people of God. See, God has not organized, but he orchestrated one day out of the week for us to rest. People consider that Sunday, but really it's a Saturday going into a Sunday. But if you work on a Saturday, if you till the ground on a Saturday, then maybe your day of rest will be on a Friday, or it will be on another day. And so the Lord is talking about, this is about another day. He says, there remains then a Sabbath rest for the people of God. So it doesn't necessarily have to be on a Saturday, but there has to be a day of rest. So let us therefore make every effort to enter that rest so that no one will perish by following their example of disobedience. See, even resting, we have to do that in obedience. Even in our laying down, it still have to be in our obedience to God. And this is the word that I'm bringing you to there in verse number 12. We've heard it and we heard it again, but we're going to hear it again today. See, for the word of God is alive and it's active. It's sharper than a double-edged sword, that it penetrates even to dividing the soul and the spirit, the joints and the marrow, that it judges the thoughts and the attitudes of the heart. See, there's nothing in all creation is hidden from God's sight. God has a perfect sight. And everything is uncovered and it's laid bare before the eyes of him to whom we must give an account. See, us as Christians, even though we may take physical rest, okay, there's still the taking in of God's word. See, right now, I'm working because I'm working this gospel. I'm giving the word of God out. But also, too, there is a time where I'm just resting and I'm taking in the Word of God. See, the Word of God is always for me first. It's just like I was sharing with you. The mother goes and prepares and see what she has and see what she can give. And she creates this phenomenal dish. And then later on, it becomes a famous dish. Oh, this is how you did it. You see what I'm saying? And this is the Word of God. This Word of God, it's working. This Word of God is active. This Word of God is powerful. This Word of God is alive. And see, there's certain areas in our lives where God wants to increase us in our belief for healing, where God wants to increase us in our belief for deliverance, where God wants to increase us in so many ways, but we need the Word of God. We need the Word of God to be our sword. We need the Word of God to work and to will according to His way and according to His promise. As they say, where there's a will, there's a way. And as we have this perfect Word of God, God knows when you're going to need this sword. And what I was looking at in the study of carrying this sword, which is wielded to the right hand, that we as soldiers are wielded with this sword on our right hand, and we have the shield of faith, that we are always warring in the things of the Spirit, that it is by faith that we receive. It is by faith that we tear down the strongholds of the enemy. It is by faith that we weary off all the darts of the devil while we have the sword that is wielded. In other words, this is something that cannot be released, that cannot be let go, that it is in our hand to use. And it's powerful. And it's mighty. And you know, Jesus didn't have to carry the sword. In other words, the sword is a representative of the Word of God. Remember in John, there in chapter 1, it talks about how Jesus was the Word. And the Word was with God, and the Word of God dwelt among us. See, that's Jesus. And when Jesus is living in us, we have to be so careful with that Word, because Jesus is the Word. And the more that He is come so alive within us, you know what? I'm not going to fear, because God is with me. God is wielding this way out of these problems and these situations. And I can work with a sword all day long. But if I don't have the combination of the sword of the Spirit as well as the shield of faith, then I'm going to get tired. So I have to work them together. And I have to work them with the Word of God. And I'm excited about this Word of God for you. And I'm praying that this Word has increased you in your heart, in your soul, in your mind, and in your strength. You can continually to study out this in Ephesians. There, in chapter 6, about the soldier and about putting on the full armor of God. And as we do that, we are His servants. We are in the Lord's army. And I'm not going to work the fear. I'll have a reverential fear for God. But when the enemy throws that dart, you know what? I'm going to activate this shield of faith. No. My whole household is saved. I believe. No sickness and disease can dwell in my home. I plead the blood of Jesus. We activate the word of God and we apply it to our lives. And we see God get the glory as we continually to triumph here in this earth, here in this atmosphere, here in this form, as we give him all the honor and all the glory. Let us pray, church. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the access point of entering the spiritual realm. We know, Father God, that there is a spiritual warfare that is happening in the atmosphere for our lives, for our hearts, for our souls, for our minds. Father God, activate us today in our lives to the word of God, which is the truth. That just as your word has spoken, that the word of God is alive and it is active and it is sharper than any double-edged sword, that it is penetrating even to the dividing of the soul and of the spirit, even to the joints and unto the marrow, Lord, it is being treated and it judges the thoughts and the attitudes of our hearts. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you are weighing our hearts. You are weighing our lives. And we connect with you today that I will not fear, because God, the almighty, saving, deliverance, setting free, my Lord, my God, is with us, whom never leaves us or forsakes us. God bless you, church. Thank you for traveling grace here with me, Tina Viesca, cruzando fronteras, con una voz de alerta, crossing borders with a voice of alert. I want you to stay connected. I want you to know that you are loved by God. I want you to know that I want to see you mature in your faith. I want to see you climb up those mountains. Come on now. We are literally up a new mountain there in Nigeria, just to kind of give you some updates. And you know, it's a free willy, as you will. It's a free willy mountain. In other words, many people go there from all different walks of life, and they are praying on that mountain. They are interceding on that mountain. They are going through programs on that mountain, and people are seeing and seeking for the hand of God to work on their lives, to see God to move in great and mighty ways. Hey, we're still believing for those in Pakistan. We want to upgrade the orphanage home, amen. The facilities need to be very much restored in many ways. There's broken places. They literally, you know, don't have sinks. It's just like a little hose kind of coming through there. You know, and things have to be sanitized. Things have to be cleaned. You know how we are here in our greater Fort Worth area, as well as in all the United States. You know, we have so many things that we've got different kind of antiseptic sprays, and we got all these things to keep us out of clear from harm's way, and the blood of Jesus, I'm telling you, that is applied, and they got the blood of Jesus, amen. But we just want to make it comfortable and showing the love of God and having them access to the facilities there in the orphanage center as well. Pray for Pastor Daniel all the way in India, amen. There was something going on with his neck, amen. He's wearing a brace on it right now. But, you know, I know that the Lord has used him much and mightily. The effectiveness of COVID has kind of stopped them on and off for having church within the temple. in the four walls, but they're still going into the homes. They're still going in to the communities as God permits, at God's wills, with all safety, amen, and reaching and touching lives of the individuals, amen, that are really being rescued from so many false gods and false beliefs, and knowing that they are facing severe persecutions. And so thank you for your love, your support towards this ministry. Thank you for giving towards the radio, and just so many ways that we can be a blessing as we are connecting. And you know, if you could say, you know what, I just came across this and I really want to do something, I want to share with you right now that if you've not given your life to the Lord, we need to do so today. Amen. Let us say that prayer of repentance as we channel out today. And hey, if you could say, you know what, I am a born-again believer, I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, you know, maybe you've backslidden and you've been doing the two-step going backwards. You know, just rededicate your life. Rededicate your life. Take the time and spend this time with Jesus. Amen. And just rededicate your life. Say, Father God, I thank you, Lord. I believe that you died on the cross for me. I thank you, Lord, for taking my sin, my shame, my guilt. I thank you, Lord, for restoring back the joy of my salvation within my life. I know that you died on the cross for me, and on the third day, Lord, you rose again. So I ask you, Lord, and I ask the Holy Spirit to come into my heart, to come into my life. Come and be real. Show me the way. Lead me the way. Guide me in the way of your truth here today. Have your way as I give my life, my heart, my soul, and my mind, and I give it all to you. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen and amen. Church, if you said that prayer, feel free to message me. We can continually to pray and to pray on. Amen. I am building, I guess, a little off page to where we can be coming into some spiritual counseling. Amen. Maybe just 30 minutes out of your day. Amen. And there is a minimum amount of fee of $50. If there is something that's a little bit more weighing and crucial, you know, don't shy away. Don't shy away. Message me. Let me know. I can work out something with you. Amen. We've helped out in different areas, even in the immigration, with those that have gone through some type of trauma here and filled out the paperwork for that as well. Amen. I believe those are 6 to 9 sessions. Amen. That we have done in the past as well. And we can do that for you as well. Amen. Knowing that, God is leading us to doing so many things, so that he can continually to increase us in the plan of power that God wants us to move in. Amen. And so we walk by faith and not by sight. Be filled today with God's power, God's anointing, and the Holy Spirit. Because when the Holy Spirit is infilling inside of you, I'm telling you, brokes of chains, heavy laden, is gone. And in Jesus' mighty name, I'm telling you, Jesus sets us free. Once again, we love you, church. Thank you for soaring high with me. And we will see you so very soon. God bless you, church. Amen and amen.